Hello friends, welcome to Learn Next. So today we'll discuss the July 3rd week current affairs of 2020. And let's start with the first question. Which guidelines have been released by Union Human Resource Development Ministry for digital education? Correct answer is Pragyata guidelines. So, Union Human Resource Development Minister Sri Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank released Pragyata guidelines on digital education through online medium in New Delhi. The minister informed that Pragyata guidelines have been developed from the perspective of learners with a focus on digital education for students who are presently at home due to lockdown. Next, who has become the new president of South American country Suriname? Correct answer is Chandrika Prasad Santokhi. So, South American country Suriname elects Indian origin Chandrika Prasad Santokhi as its president. He replaced Desi Butters. The 61-year-old Santokhi belongs to the Progressive Reform Party. Next, which organization developed P-7 heavy drop system for IL-76 aircraft? Correct answer is Defense Research and Development Organization or DRDO. So, Defense Research and Development Organization has developed P-7 heavy drop system, which is capable of paradropping military stores up to 7-ton weight class from IL-76 aircraft. So Dr. G. Satish Reddy is the chairman of DRDO and DRDO headquarters is in New Delhi. Next, who became the new chairman of SCL Technologies? Correct answer is Roshni Nadar Malhotra. So, SCL Technologies announced that its founder and chairman Shiv Nadar stepped down from the role and the company's board of directors has appointed his daughter Roshni Nadar Malhotra as the new chairperson with immediate effect. Next, which country launched a mission titled as Hope to Mars? Correct answer is the United Arab Emirates or UAE. So a United Arab Emirates spacecraft rocketed away a 7-month journey to Mars, kicking off the Arab world's first interplanetary mission. The liftoff of the Mars orbiter named Amal or Hope. So, from Japan marked the start of a rush to fly to Earth's neighbor that includes attempts by China and the United States. Next, who has been appointed as the new private secretary to the President of India, Ramnath Kovind? Correct answer is P. Pravin Siddharth. So, a 2001 batch Indian Revenue Service Income Tax Cadre Officer P. Pravin Siddharth has been appointed as the private secretary to President Ramnath Kovind. Mr. Siddharth has replaced Vikram Singh. Next, Lalji Tandon, who passed away recently, was the governor of which state? Correct answer is Madhya Pradesh. So, Madhya Pradesh governor Lalji Tandon passed away after a prolonged illness at the age of 85. Uttar Pradesh Governor Anandiben Patel was given the additional charge of Madhya Pradesh. Next, who has been appointed as the MD and CEO of Karur Vysya Bank? Correct answer is Ramesh Babu Bodhu. So, Karur Vysya Bank Board of Directors has co-opted Ramesh Babu Bodhu as an additional director and appointed him managing director and chief executive officer for 3 years. Next, which country will host FIFA World Cup 2022, whose schedule was announced recently? Correct answer is Qatar. So FIFA announced schedule for World Cup 2022 hosts Qatar to kick off tournament from November 21st to December 18, 2022. So Gianni Infantino is the president of FIFA and FIFA headquarters is in Zurich, Switzerland. Next, who has become the first woman prime minister of Gabon? Correct answer is Rose Christine Osuka Raponda. So the president of Gabon, Ali Bonga Ondimba, has appointed the country's first female prime minister, Rose Christine Osuka Raponda. Next, which nation became the first nation to finish human trials for COVID-19 vaccine? Correct answer is Russia. So Russia has become the first nation to complete clinical trials of COVID-19 vaccine on humans, and the results have proven the medication's effectiveness. So Moscow is the capital and Russian ruble is the currency of Russia. Next, who has been appointed as the new MD and CEO of SBI Cards and Payment Services? Correct answer is Ashwini Kumar Tewari. SBI Cards and Payment Services, the country's second largest credit card issuer, has a new managing director and CEO in Ashwini Kumar Tewari. Next, what is the theme of Nelson Mandela International Day 2020? Correct answer is Take Action, Inspire Change. So the United Nations Nelson Mandela International Day is annually celebrated on July 18th as the birth anniversary of Nelson Mandela to recognize his contribution in creating a democratic South Africa. The theme of 2020 is Take Action, Inspire Change. Next, which state launched Nabin Rojgar Chhatri Yojana for Scheduled Caste? Correct answer is Uttar Pradesh. So Yogi Adityanath, Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, launched Nabin Rojgar Chhatri Yojana, an all-round development scheme for the Scheduled Caste, and provide financial assistance to support people to become self-dependent. Next, who won the Hungarian Grand Prix 2020? Correct answer is Lewis Hamilton. So Lewis Hamilton won the 8th Hungarian Grand Prix 2020 at Hungaroring, Mogyoród, Hungary. So Max Verstappen was second, followed by Valtteri Bottas at the third spot. Next, which team won the 34th La Liga title 2020? Correct answer is Real Madrid. So Real Madrid were crowned La Liga champions for the 34th time after Karim Benzema scored twice in a 2-1 victory over Villarreal, which clinched the title with one game to spare. Next, on the name of whom Rajya Sabha Secretariat has launched the Employees Welfare Scheme? Correct answer is Arun Jaitley. So Employees Welfare Scheme launched in Arun Jaitley's name in Rajya Sabha. The scheme seeks to benefit Group C employees of the secretariat by awarding their children 3 scholarships for higher technical and professional education. Next, which state launched One Stop Shop Scheme? Correct answer is Rajasthan. So Rajasthan Cabinet has approved one stop shop scheme to fast track investment and capacity expansion proposals by facilitating time bound approvals and clearances. It will help revive industries in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic. Next, who became the first recipient of Gulbenkian Prize for Humanity? Correct answer is Greta Thunberg. So the first edition of the Gulbenkian Prize for Humanity has been awarded to Greta Thunberg. The young Swedish environmental activist was selected among 136 nominees. Next, who has been appointed as the MD and CEO of SBI General Insurance Company? Correct answer is Prakash Chandra Kanpal. So, non-life insurer SBI General Insurance announced the appointment of Prakash Chandra Kanpal as its new managing director and chief executive officer. Next, what is the theme of India Ideas Summit 2020? Correct answer is Building a Better Future. So, Prime Minister Modi addressed the India Ideas Summit, which was held from July 21st to 22nd, 2020. The theme for this year's summit was Building a Better Future. The summit is being hosted by the US-India Business Council. Next, which country has added Reliance Jio among clean telcos companies list? Correct answer is United States. So the United States has listed Reliance Jio among the companies that are becoming clean telcos, saying they are rejecting doing business with tools of the Chinese Communist Party surveillance state like Huawei. Next, who has been appointed as the new non-executive chairman of Bajaj Finance? And the correct answer is Sanjeev Bajaj. So the company's board has approved the appointment of Sanjeev Bajaj as non-executive chairman of the companies with effect from August 1, 2020 in place of Rahul Bajaj. Next, which card has been launched by FarmPay for teenagers to let them make payments independently? Correct answer is FarmPay card. So FarmPay, India's first new bank for teenagers in partnership with IDFC First Bank, launched India's first numberless card, Farm Card. So the Farm Pay with National Payments Corporation of India developed this card. Next, which is the South Asia's first league that joined World League Forum? Correct answer is Indian Super League. So the Indian Super League is the first league from South Asia and seventh in Asia to join the prestigious World Leagues Forum. So this is all for this video, and these were some important current affairs of July 3rd week of 2020. Please like, share and subscribe our channel Learn Next to get regular updates. Thank you.